Jesus Christ, beloved, it is a good thing that God has done to set aside this day all the way back at creation for His worship and our rest, for this is indeed the Lord's Day. And so we come into His courts with thanksgiving, and we know that we are having a foretaste, an appetizer rather, if we put it in Dylan language, right? An appetizer of the glories that await us in heaven eternal. And so we join the heavenly courts in singing tonight, in praising our God using instruments. And we are so thrilled that you are with us. A special introduction, really. My name is Pastor Matthew Adams. I am the lead pastor here at First Presbyterian Church. Been serving in this capacity for going on 4 years now. Working on my 11th year here at the church, serving on their ministry staff. And as a member of the elders here, we are thankful that our visitors are here with us to worship our God together in spirit and in truth. And so let me draw your attention to a few things in your bulletin. We are thrilled that we can have these this evening to guide you through the program. But if you look on page 9, we are indebted to many people that made this come together. How about that? And so, of course, you see our guest artists there, Mr. Jackson Stone and Mr. Jim Hepler. You see their bio there beside their names. And then also our community choral ensemble that we are thrilled to have here worshiping with us. And then, of course, we are indebted to Lincoln Pipe Organs of Lincolnton, North Carolina, for their work on our organ. And then Mr. Peter Cudd on his restoration of our 1895 Steinway Grand Piano. And if you notice that line right under that announcement there, you know that Mr. John Law, our former organist, donated that piano as a gift to our church. And that prelude, "When I Survey the Wondrous Cross," was in memory of him, as it was his favorite hymn. As he has passed on to glory, he is enjoying the fullness of heaven eternal. And we know that even though he would love to be here with us, he'd much rather be there worshiping around his Savior. And so we miss him, but we are also envious of him, for we know that he is experiencing Christ, his eternal inheritance. It is good for us to enter into worship using God's word. And so if you will stand out of reverence to his word, we'll read together Psalm 24. I'll read the regular print and you'll respond with the bold. "The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and all those who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord, and who shall stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not lift up his soul to what is false, and does not swear deceitfully. He will receive blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty. The Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, and lift them up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory." You may be seated. As we come into the courts of this majestic Lord, this sovereign creator of all things, we know that in his good mercy, he gives us gifts to enjoy. And two of those gifts you will hear this evening as we dedicate this Lincoln pipe organ and this Steinway grand piano. And so let me read the words of consecration and dedication. "Father, your people worship you with many voices and sounds in times of joy and sorrow. Move us to express the wonder, the power, and the glory of your creation and your salvation in the music we make and in the songs we sing. Praise him with the sound of trumpets. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him upon the lute and the harp. We dedicate these instruments in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen." It is good for us to give thanks for what the Lord has given us. And so we are going to sing praise and thanksgivings to our God using the hymn, "Holy,
Holy, Holy. If the choir would come on up, or the men of the choir would come on up, we'll sing that hymn together. It is there on page 10 of your bulletin.
Thank you.
As we just sang, our God is a triune God, existent in Father, Son, and Spirit. And it is He who has called us to worship. It is He who has given us good gifts from above. It is He who sent His only begotten Son to be a ransom for many. Amen. And it is He that we give adoration and praise. And so as we continue to sing and to worship and to hear God speak through the preaching and the reading of His Word, we come to read Psalm 150. Please stand as you are able, and let's read together, following the same pattern. I'll read the regular, and you'll respond with the bold. Praise the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His mighty heavens. Praise Him for His mighty deeds. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness. Praise Him with trumpet sound. Praise Him with lute and harp. Praise Him with tambourine and dance. Praise Him with strings and pipe. Praise Him with sounding cymbals. Praise Him with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. You may be seated. At the Book of Common Prayer, there is a proclamation, a declaration of peace and blessing for these gifts, for this sanctuary, and for these people. Please hear the words. Peace be to this house and to all who enter here. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. May our Lord Jesus Christ put a seal upon this place and protect it from all evil and darkness, that it may be a beacon of His truth and His love. Amen. It is good for us to continue singing praises to our God. And so if you will please stand as you are able and turn to our next hymn, To God Be the Glory.
Thank you.
seated. That singing doesn't make you excited for heaven, I don't know what will. As we transition to our dedicatory, that's a big un-Dylan word, Jim. As we move into our dedication recital, and as we begin to transition into that point, let me just take a moment of personal privilege here to just really celebrate the work that these two men, Jim and Jackson, have done for your enjoyment and for God's glory. We are so thankful for them sharing their talents with us, and personally it has been a great joy to have a lunch date every Friday for the past couple of months and to enjoy these brothers in fellowship. And so we will go ahead and transition to that point now.
Let me just say what a wonderful privilege it is to be with you today, to hear this singing and to enjoy the fellowship of God's people. I have enjoyed so much coming and being a part of this, and I feel like I've been a part of the church fellowship as I've been coming back and forth over the last few weeks and meeting with your pastor and practicing with Jackson and meeting people in the church family. You're a wonderful family here, and it's a joy and a privilege to be with you today. What a wonderful instrument this is, these both are, as we celebrate them today and as we observe this time of dedicating them to God's glory and to your use. They are, it's a tribute to you, it's a tribute to God to be able to have this kind of instruments to lead and guide you in worship. At this time, we're just going to start the recital, and this is the first piece is going to be a tuba tune. Some organs have a tuba on them, and all that a tuba is on an organ is just a large-scale trumpet. And you don't have a tuba, but you do have a large-scale trumpet, so we're letting that be our tuba today for C.S. Lang's tuba tune in D major.
Thank you.
And they're going to let you hear a lot of different sounds from the organ. That's why I selected them. Starts off with a soft flute sound. Then it's going to build, and it's going to get to close to full organ. And then it's going to drop right back down to the flutes that you hear in the beginning. Mendelssohn's Andante with variation.
Thank you.
next piece is also a set of variations, but it's from a whole different time period. And this shows off the organ in a different way than these other pieces just did. One of the things you might want to listen for, the organ has two trumpets, one on the grate and one on the swell, the top keyboard. You're going to hear the two trumpets in dialogue with each other. And you're going to hear at the end this little device called a zimbalstern, little bells that just turn around and rotate. And so some things that you can listen for and enjoy.
Thank you.
a little flute solo. It's kind of a last minute addition to this program. As you get to know an organ, you understand its personality and find little things on it that really intrigue you and so on. The 4-foot harmonic flute on the swell has become my favorite stop, and I thought I've got to do something to feature that little stop. So this is a real short little piece called Flute Solo, and it's going to feature your harmonic flute. Move into a whole different kind of music now, music from the Romantic era. I love this piece. It's been one of my favorites for many, many years. I heard, as a matter of fact, I heard the composer of the piece that's going to follow this by Robert Elmore. I heard him play it in a recital many years ago, along with the piece that I'm going to play next. And I fell in love with it. But what I like about it is that it takes us from the whisper of an organ to the roar of the organ, and then right back down to the whisper. So you'll hear all of that in the Adagio in E major.
Thank you.
assist me there at the end. It calls for a 32-foot, and there's not one on this organ, but you can kind of create it, but you have to have 2 feet, and you can't work a swell pedal, so Jackson worked the swell pedal. Thank you, Jackson. The next piece is a Pavane by Robert Elmore. Kind of bridged the romantic and contemporary eras, and this piece explores a lot of new harmonies, but you'll hear a lot of other sounds on this organ too. You'll hear a flute solo, you'll hear a reed solo, and some of the pretty sounds that are on this organ.
Thank you.
style now. The North German School of Organ Music was one of the real instrumental developments of organ music. And a lot of times we think of Johann Sebastian Bach, but we're actually going to start today with one of his mentors, Dietrich Buxtehude. And this is his Toccata and Fugue in F major, and you're going to hear the North German Baroque sound.
Thank you.
Max is making a dash for the piano. We're going to play a piano organ duet for you. When we were first talking about this recital, John Law said, who can we get to play the piano so that it could be heard with the organ? And at that time, I was just getting to know Jackson. Didn't know a whole lot about what his abilities were or anything like that, but I said, let me see. Then I heard him play for Dream Girls. And did any of you hear that over at Florence Little Theater? And I heard him play for Dream Girls, and I called John Law, and I said, John, he can do it, you know. And we are doing this duet. This is the hymn we gather together to ask the Lord's blessing. And that's what we're doing this afternoon. On these two instruments, we're asking God's blessing on them as they're used for his glory. And this will be a setting of that hymn. Such a fine person and just such a fine Christian man.
Amen.
And he is going to make a real credit to the world of church music. Thank you, Jackson. That's right. That's right. And Kathy just reminded me, and he was the co-valedictorian at Dillon High School this year as well. Got it all.
Thank you.
John Law and I first began to talk about this recital, one of the requests he made, he said, I know you're going to need to do a lot of organ repertoire, but I want you to include some things that are familiar for people. And he didn't have to twist my arm because I grew up on the hymns of the church and loved them. And one of my favorites is Great is Thy Faithfulness. The verses from Lamentations, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Thank you.
Next one is another one of my very favorite hymns, It Is Well With My Soul. Just gonna play it for you. Piece was one more request by John Law. He heard me play it at another organ dedication one time, came to hear it at some of our organ concerts, I think in Bennettsville, and I asked him what he wanted to close the recital with, and I mentioned a couple of pieces, and he just kind of shook his head, and I said, well, he said, the Grand Fantasia, and I knew what he wanted. So this is a setting of Joy to the World, The Lord Has Come. It was written for the big Aeolians pipe organ at Longwood Gardens in New Jersey. And it's a showpiece. The feet go crazy. It's a workout. So I've done my aerobics when I finish this piece.
Thank you.
word says that where two or three are gathered in the name of the Lord, he is there in their midst. And surely we have known that the Lord God Almighty has been with us this evening. We have had a powerful night of music and worship and praise and thanksgiving, and it is fitting for us to conclude with a hymn, God of Grace and God of Glory. And then I think that there's a little bit of an encore right after the hymn, and then I'll give some instructions before the benediction. But now let's stand and sing that last hymn on page 12 of your bulletin, God of Grace and God of Glory. Please note that stanza 4 will be sung a cappella. And Jackson, take it away.
Thank you.
encore that we're going to do. One Friday when I was over here, Jackson said, I want to learn the Paul Mons God of Grace. I said, okay, I'll bring it to you next week. So I brought it to him the next Friday, and then the following Friday, I came back and he said, well, I've learned the pedal part, and the pedal part's the hardest part, you know, in this piece. And I said, well, I'll tell you what, you play the pedal part and I'll play the manuals. Well, it just kind of, we enjoyed doing it. And I said, you know what, that would be a perfect encore for the recital, so here's your encore.
Showing off. And so we are so excited to be able to even do that. And so please join us for a few moments of fellowship on the front lawn. Please be mindful of all the social distancing protocols that are in place. And we look forward to the next time that we're able to join together yet again to sing praises and to worship. Now, please stand and let's receive the Lord's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord lift up his countenance to you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Spirit, we pray. Amen.